Okay, in this video, we're going to be covering the installation of the upper intake manifold, normally referred to as plenum. And we have our gasket here in place already. And it snaps, it's a plastic gasket, it snaps into place here. And here has a couple of clips that snap right in, and they also have some dowel pins that snap into place as well in a few places. You also want to snap in that small tube that runs to the PECV valve that's on the front of the engine. So you want to snap it in the front in the center. And that holds holds the tube in place. So you want to, of course, this is all done after you have thoroughly cleaned all mating surfaces and taken out any old gasket material and grease, oil, and grime. And I cannot stress enough how important it is to make sure it's very clean. And you can use, after you get all the gasket material off, you can use denatured alcohol or acetone to get all the any oil or grime that may be on there, or grease. And what we're going to do, this is the area that that is infamous for in these engines. This is a 97 Pontiac Grand Prix with a 3800 Series 2 V6, and which is the 3.8 liter engine. 3800 being the 3800 CCs. If you can convert the 3.8 liter to CCs, it would be 3,800, and that's the capacity, the cylinder or combustion chamber volume of the engine. And normally, these cars are referred, or these engines are referred to the 3,800 V6 Series 2 engines. So we're ready to install this, and since this area here, when you check your plenum before you put your gasket on, just make sure that there's no pitting or degradation in this area. Many times, if you remove your plenum, it's a good idea. If you see any kind of degradation, or pitting right around this area here, that comes, it's a tube, the riser that comes from the EGR valve, you may want to probably be better off getting a new plenum. Many times that's the best way to go. And we'll be ready to install the new plenum after, of course, we've clean out. You want to be make sure that you clean out this entire area of the top of the lower intake manifold with a putty knife and or a gasket scraper. Make sure that all this whole area, and in fact the entire area around, it's free of any leftover gasket and grease, grime, or oil that may be on there. So you want to scrape everything off, and then use denatured alcohol or acetone to make sure that you get all the grease and grime. It has to be completely clean, free of dirt, gasket material, grease, or oil. Have to be completely devoid of any foreign matter, and of any grease or oil that might be on there. So, and completely dry. To make it a little speedier, the actual original EGR tube is a riser. It's this one here. This one is this car's. This engine actually is notorious for this area here failing on the plenum. And we'll show you the area here. This area here on the plenum normally fails because of the hot gases coming out of the EGR tube here, this EGR riser that comes in right here from the exhaust and up into this tube and then subsequently into the plenum here. And then what it'll do, see if we can show you here. As you can see here, you might be able to see here, this area has been degraded and even part of it broken. And this is where it fails and starts leaking coolant, water and antifreeze, coolant. So from this holes here, because this gets degraded and pitted and from the heat from this tube. So the fix for this, it's normally most of the manifolds that you would, the new plenums or new upper intake manifolds that you will buy normally have a fix for this condition, which is, as you can see, this we reinstalled this tube, we removed and we placed a new tube, which is smaller in diameter and will fit with some area around it. It won't be so tight as this one. This one was the original one. It fits a little tight here. See if I can show you this. The original one fits real tight, actually touching the plenum, which is plastic, so then all the hot the heat degrades the plastic and then it fails. So the new one, it's a smaller diameter to fix that problem. Now this one has to be, you have to take this one out, and the way we accomplish that is you take a wrench such as this one and then you would put it around it, or which is similar to a monkey wrench, and then you can use a monkey wrench if you've got a small enough monkey wrench that you can fit here, or one of these wrenches, or some way that you can hold on to this tube, and then with a twisting action you want to pull it up, pull it out of its bore, and then you would put this one in. And you will have instructions if like for with our new plenum came instructions on doing this, and if it doesn't fit completely, if it's a little loose, and the instructions will call for putting some adhesive on here and to get this to be nice and tight. And then once you get this done, and everything is clean, then you're ready to get the new plenum in place. Okay, here we have our new plenum or upper intake manifold. And at first glance, when you open the box, you may say, oh, well, this looks pretty much the same as my old one. But upon closer inspection, you'll see several improvements. Namely, beefier area around the bolt holes. Most importantly, the redesigned area around the EGR passage at the riser, and a smaller diameter EGR riser, which is the area that is notorious in these engines for failing, for actually making the degrading the plastic area of the plenum around the tube, because this tube gets very hot. It actually brings in the hot gases from the exhaust. So this is where these engines are. They're notorious for failing around this area here. Now, so this is like we mentioned earlier. This is an upgrade. So it's an actual kit. It's not just the manifold. It's an actual kit that comes with the upgraded smaller diameter tube. It's got the gaskets. Also has several O-rings for your one of them goes, the smaller black O-ring goes around the vacuum tube on the left side of the engine towards a firewall. And so there is some assembly required. You also have larger the black O-rings will go as for the PCB valve, your positive crankcase ventilation valve, which is inside this area here underneath the pressure sensor. And there will be an orange, larger orange O-ring, which goes inside the PCV cavity as well, to seal this area here below the pressure sensor. And you'll have nice instructions on all this. You'll have to snap this some of these components in place, plus set the gasket in place and your EGR tube inside the plenum as well. So once you set that up and set your gasket in place correctly, and it has some guide double pins that go into the guide holes, and once you snap that in place and press it in its correct spot, then you're ready to install your manifold. Also, you'll need it comes with a set of a new set of studs for the intake for the throttle body. So you want to screw those in with the smaller side of the threads going into the manifold. So you have the longer side of the threads for the studs going towards the throttle body. You can screw those in place. And once everything, you also want to clean the, even though it's brand new, you want to clean the mating surfaces here before you install your gasket. And because you want to make sure there's no oil, grease, or not even fingerprints on it. So, and you also need to install your gasket for the throttle body right here, which is the blue one that you see here. And there'll be nice instructions in the package with torque, with the torque specs. And it's a nice kit. This is a Dorman kit. And as aforementioned, you want to make sure that it's the whichever one you get, which brand you get, you want to make sure it's an upgrade, especially with this EGR tube of a smaller diameter to address the notorious problems these engines have with the degrading of the plenum around the EGR riser. So, having said that, and making sure that everything's clean and ready to go, we can now put our manifold in place. And you want to make sure that, especially around the EGR tube, that you place it so you don't nick the tube. Or I should say, you don't nick the gasket or damage it with that EGR tube. You should also test the all the threads and make sure that they're nice and clean, and that it's a good idea to use a tap of the appropriate size and chase the threads to make sure that they're all nice and clean. And if you don't have a tap, it's a good idea to clean the screws with penetrating oil or solvent or a degreaser, and then clean the threads real good, and then run them in and out a few times to make sure that you all the threads are clean, and so you can get an accurate torque reading, especially on a application like this, when the torque is not a really high torque, so you don't want to get the wrong torque reading. And what we do here before we start setting the screws, we want to make it easier to install the throttle body. You want to put it in place, and then raise it. Put the plenum or upper manifold in place, and then raise it slightly, and place the throttle body on the studs, and then lower it again. That way, you can clear this bracket here that we moved out of the way, and that it's still kind of slightly in the way of the throttle body. Also, like always, making sure that not to damage the honeycomb in the front of the throttle body. And the plenum or upper intake manifold, the longest stud, the actual stud, goes on the closest to the EGR valve. And the second largest goes on the other side of the throttle body. And then all the other bolts are the same size. You've seen some of our videos. We are in the habit of collecting small containers such as this one, and then we'll have them ready when they disassemble the engine. We'll just write down where the screws came from, like this one. I don't know if you can see it, this plenum on it, and that'll make it really easy for you when it comes time to assemble it. Instead of be searching for the bolts, you go right to it. You get okay, get the plenum bolts. And your other long bolt, it goes here, and it's actually a stud that holds a bracket that goes around the EGR valve right here on this side of it. So you got a long bolt here and a long stud this on this end here. which is closest to the driver's side and closest to the EGR valve. Here will be your, here goes your, you will connect your intake here. Your throttle valve, actually, right here. So we got all our bolts in, and we've, you want to gently approach, tighten them evenly, starting in the center in a crisscross pattern. And for this one, we'll use our tighten tools. It's a hollow socket. You can use a deep socket as well. These are hollow sockets and extensions. Real neat. Lifesaver. Titan Tools Exo Drive. You can go. It'll go right through the. You got a long stud. It'll go right through. You don't need a deep socket. This one will be a 10 millimeter for this one. And the nice thing about this kit as well is the actual tightening sequence. It's printed on the neck here, where close to the throttle body, and also the with a torque range, the torque setting, and each bolt hole has a number indicating the sequence. Because you start like number one, the middle bolt, the center bolt, and the left of the engine or the rear, and then you come across to the second, and so forth. Then you go towards the outsides. You want to approach your target torque in a pattern, in a crisscross pattern, starting from the center. They all snug, then you will get our torque wrench. You want to torque them in three steps. We're going to go to 89 inch pounds, and I want to make that real clear. That's 89 inch pounds, not foot pounds. 89 inch pounds, and we want to do that in three logical steps, which will make it. The first one would be 22. The second one will be 44, and the third step in the sequence will be to reach 89. So we want to do the three steps in the pattern, starting with bolt number one. Then this will be bolt number two. So one in the at the rear or left of the engine center, front center. On the right side of the engine will be number two. We'll go to number three, and then we'll go to number four, and then five will be to here, and then six will be here, seven will be next to the EGR valve, and eight will be across in the front, and then nine will be next behind or to the left of the PCV valve, and number 10 will be in front or to the right of the PCV valve. And like I mentioned earlier, the kit comes with a nice set of instructions with the bolt pattern and the torque ratings, so for your convenience. So we'll start with number one. And we'll go to number two. And so on. Okay, and we're down to our last bolt, and that concludes the third step of the tightening sequence. and we've torqued all our bolts to 89 inch pounds for that upper intake manifold, usually referred to as plenum. And that concludes the installation of the plenum on a 97 Pontiac Grand Prix with a 3800 Series 2 engine. Hope this video was helpful, and thanks for watching. Next, we'll be installing the throttle body here on the plenum, and we'll show you how to do that.
And I think that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this video will be helpful. And please don't forget to subscribe and like and share. And as always, let's make peace.